Hello, and welcome to the February market update. My name is Brad McMillan. I'm Commonwealth's Chief Investment Officer. This month, we have three things to talk about. The first is the U.S. economy, which continues to do well. The second is the U.S. financial markets, which had a tough month. And the third is the rest of the world, which largely explains just why the U.S. markets had a tough month. Let's start off with the U.S. economy. The headline news was that the economy grew by about 2.6% in the last quarter, which isn't bad, but it was down from about 5% the previous quarter, which raises the question, what the heck happened? Well, nothing really substantially happened. There are a couple of reasons for this. The first is statistical. That 5 was actually a little bit higher than it should have been, and the 2.6 is a little bit lower. So if you adjust for kind of some of the underlying numbers, if you normalize them, it's about 4.3 and about 3.4, which is a much smaller drop and still very strong growth. The other factors in there are businesses are investing less. Not a problem, largely due to lower oil prices, which again is an overall positive factor, but it is a one-time hit. The third thing is that exports went down and imports went up because the dollar is so strong. Those are things we'll talk about in the next two sections. Because the real question here is, even though the economy is doing well, and I would point out that we created more jobs last year than we have in any year since 1999. Think about that. That's boom times. I would point out that consumer confidence is at the highest level than it has been since 2007. Again, boom times. Consumer spending is picking up. And in fact, that's over two-thirds of the economy. So we have a very solid economic foundation for the U.S. economy as a whole. Even given that, the fact that U.S. markets got hit in January, the major indices were down between 2 and 4%, which is the worst it's been since November 2012, suggests there's a disconnect there. There are a couple of things going on. The first is lower oil prices. Now, this is great for the economy as a whole, but it hits energy companies' earnings and share prices hard. And that in and of itself was a major part of the damage. The second part was a strong U.S. dollar. Now, there's a couple of things going into that. The first of which is the U.S. economy is actually doing very well. That's one of the major reasons we have a strong dollar. And everywhere else in the world isn't doing as well. But the problem is, from a corporate perspective, companies that sell a lot outside of the U.S., they're selling less because there's economic weakness. And what they do sell, when you translate it back into dollars, is worth less. So these are both results of good factors for the U.S., but they do hit the U.S. stock market and U.S. companies in the short term. So let's go to the rest of the world for a second. What is causing this problem? First of all, both Europe and Japan have not been able to break out of kind of the low growth trap. They've been stuck there, unemployment is too high, they don't have the consumer demand, and they haven't been able to do what was necessary. They've actually just recently started to try and do that. They've started doing stimulus measures. Both the European Central Bank and the Japanese Central Bank have launched Federal Reserve-style quantitative easing programs, and those should help. But the question is, they're not helping yet, but they have weakened their currencies, which gives rise to the strong dollar, and the problems we've seen. Again, just as with oil prices, this is a short-term pain, long-term gain situation. So this is where we are. The U.S. economy continues to do very well. We are running into some volatility in U.S. financial markets, and in fact, it's quite probable that volatility is going to continue. Nothing to be worried about. Historically, this is absolutely normal, but we are going to see some volatility, quite possibly. But any of that volatility is going to be cushioned, first of all, by the very strong domestic U.S. economy. And second of all, by the fact that international economies, although in bad shape, are finally doing what they need to improve. Thank you for joining me, and I'll talk to you next month.